Hello students, in this part we are going to learn about some practical units. So first one is to measuring the small distances. So Fermi is basically a unit which is used at nuclear distances. That is, relation is 10 to the power minus 15. Angstrom is used for measuring the wavelength. Nanometer is also for the same. And micron is the unit which is defined in micrometer. That is 10 to the power minus 6 meter. Now next we are talking about the practical unit used for measuring the large distances. Okay, just now we have seen for the smaller distances, here the large distances. So light year, astronomical unit, and parsec. If you will see here that the light year is the distance traveled by the light in a vacuum. Ek saal mein kitni vacuum mein light travel karti, that distance is called light year. Astronomical unit is the mean distance of the earth from the sun, and parsec is the largest practical unit used in a distance of astronomy. Here they have given the relationship between the astronomical unit light year and parsec. We know that one astronomical unit is 1.5 and one light year is given this. So here only what we have done is we have find out the relation, and we have come to know that clearly that the parsec is the largest unit for measuring the large distances, after that light year, and then we have an astronomical units. Third, we are talking about the practical units for measuring the area. Baryon is used for a very small area, such as means any atom or molecule we are talking about. So baryon is used there. Acre is a large area. Hectare is also large area. Here you can see that measuring large masses, ton, quintal, slug, pound, Chandrasekhar limit. Chandrasekhar limit is the maximum or the highest practical unit for measuring the mass. Here we have the practical unit used for measuring a very small masses. Okay, very small masses. So here they have given us the atomic mass unit. That is 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. Here the practical unit measure for time. So solar day, okay, it is the time taken by the earth to complete one rotation about its own axis is called solar day. Sidereal ray, it's the time taken by the earth to complete one rotation about its own axis with respect to a distant star. Okay, first one with respect to the sun, here with distant star. So that is sidereal day. Solar year, complete one revolution of the earth. Okay, tropical year, there is a total tropical year, you can see that is the total year, the year in which there is a total solar eclipse is called tropical year. And leap year is by which divisible by 4, in which the month of February has 29 days. Okay, and then we have lunar month and shake. So shake is the practical unit of the time. Shake is the smallest practical unit of time. That is, one shake is equals to 10 to the power minus 8 second. Okay, and here are some practical units which is given for the measuring the pressure. That is, 1 bar is equals to 1 atmospheric pressure, and 1 millibar atmospheric pressure, and all the things they have given. And here I have enclosed the picture of the simple conversions of unit that we have to use in the when we will solve the numerical. So we will see some numericals related to this. Here is the question: how many light years are there in 1 meter? So if you have already seen, just now we have discussed some practical units which you have to remember. So if you will remember that one light year we have, that is 9.46 into 10 to the power 15 meter. And we need to find out that how many light years will be there in 1 meter. So how we can find it out from here? We can write here that this is the 1 light year, with this is the relation with meter. So we can find out that 1 meter is equals to, I can leave this here, 1 upon 9.46 into 10 to the power 15. Right? This is my means light year expression, only I have transposed this side. So I will get this 1.057 into 10 to the power minus 16 light year. This is the relationship, means in 1 light year we have 10 to the power minus 16 light years. 1.0057 10 to the power minus 16 light years. Okay. Second question says that what is the number of electrons that would be weigh 1 kg mass of an electron is 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. So here if you will see in this question, they have given us the mass of
each electron they have given. Okay, mass of each electron is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg, right? So if we need to calculate the total mass we need to calculate of 1 kg. Okay, total mass is equals to, we can say, 1 kg. Therefore, number of electrons which will be equals to total mass upon mass of each electron, right? So we have here total mass will be 1 kg, right? And what is the mass of each electron? 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. Both are in kg, so this is no need to convert anything. So here we will have 1.1 into 10 to the power 30. So this is the answer for this problem. See, here there are many questions related to such problems, but you need to understand the conversion and their relations. Okay. Third problem says the radius of a gold nucleus is 41.3 Fermi. Express its volume in meter cube. So here if you will see that we have one radius that is given in Fermi. So R they have given 41.3 Fermi. And just now we have discussed what is this Fermi. So Fermi is also a distance measuring unit. So what is that relation? We know that is Fermi. If we need to find it out, that means 10 to the power minus of 15, right? So I can write here 41.3 into 10 to the power minus 15 meter. And we need to calculate it, or we need to represent this R in terms of volume. So volume formula we know, that is 4 by 3 pi R cube. Okay. So what is that? 4 by 3, that is 22 by 7 into 41.3 into 10 to the power minus of 15 whole cube. So after solving this, you will get the answer 2.95 into 10 to the power minus 40 meter cube. So these are the questions which you can do, or sometimes they will ask you that how to calculate all such things. So I hope this is clear to you, how to convert such units and how to get the result from this. Okay, thank you.